Hey folks, welcome to the Triple T Thursday. For those just joining us, that's Tools, Tips, and Talk, where we'll discuss info for the knife maker. So today we're going to start and show you the magic of an induction forge. So I got this little baby a couple of months ago. I've used it off and on. Haven't shown it on the channel yet, so I figured I would do this video and show you this machine. I love this machine. You saw that little clip at the beginning of me heating something up with this thing. In real time, it took about 5 seconds to heat it up to red. So it's really cool technology. The best part is I've got my shop sealed up right now. The door is closed. I can turn the air conditioning on and use this. So in the heat of the summer, this thing is going to be a lifesaver. So how do these work? I'm not the master of how these work, but it's something with electricity flowing through the copper pipes. We'll get into a little bit more. I'm not going to give you all the science behind it, just that it works. To give you a scope, these machines, this one is about $1,100. Plus you need a cooling system that's about $300. So for under $1,500, you can get yourself just an amazing piece of equipment. So today I'm going to demonstrate this machine and I'm going to make one of those little leaves out of some mild steel just to show you what this thing can do and how to use it. Let's take a closer look. So basically, in a nutshell, these things will send an electric current through these coils, and basically anything metal in the center of these coils will heat up extremely fast. There's water being piped through the center of the coil to keep it cool, so it doesn't just melt. This is copper after all, and we're certainly approaching temperatures that would melt copper. This one is a US solid brand. It comes with a whole bunch of settings, emergency start, stop. There's some dials like how fast the heat starts, how high it will go, things on the current. I'm using a foot pedal, okay, that came with it, so it's not actually sending a current through here unless you're pressing the pedal. So we're going to crank it up. I'll turn on the water pump, and these water pumps, it's actually under here, is the same thing you'd have for a TIG welder. So I'll have links to both of these in the video description. You can get these on Amazon. So there's different kinds of coils here, and what's important is the metal going in it should be pretty close to the outside of the coil. Like if you used a big coil like this and you put a half inch rod, it's not really going to get hot. It's just too far from the outside of the coil. This one is actually for a crucible to melt non-ferrous metals in a crucible, and it'll just heat up the outside of the crucible. Some others. This one in particular is for knives, because you can pass a knife through the edge or through the center, and it's, you know, pretty narrow. I've coated this in Condursol, that's why this one is green. I'll talk about that in a little bit. Here's another one. This is just a box size. I got this one also for knives and for other flat stock that you wanted to keep close to the coil. For this, we're just going to use this one. So you'll notice this one has some high temp wrapping on it, some protection. What does happen is if you take your workpiece and actually touch it and contact more than one of these, it will actually spark. And it's really not good for the coils or for the machine. So that's why this one came with this coating, which I wish I had more of. But what I did for this one is just coat it in Condursol, which is the high temp paint that I use for heat treating. And hopefully that will be enough insulation from the, you know, just a light touch is not going to cause this to arc. So I'll heat up this metal again and just show you how hot this is going to get and how long it takes. So here we go. So about 5 seconds. And you'll notice I'm holding the other end, so. Okay, and it can get really hot. There we go. You can theoretically put your hand in this even when it's on, but if you had metal dust in your hand or something like that, it would actually heat up, so I don't recommend it.
To forge a leaf, you can start with either round bar or square bar. Here I've got half inch round bar, and the first thing I'm gonna do is just put a taper on one end. So to put in that taper, just hold your workpiece at a slight angle, so elevate the back end of it up a bit, and hold it at the edge of your anvil. And this just helps you so you don't actually hit your anvil while you're putting in the taper. Then I'll rotate it around until I get a nice square taper in the end, and I want the taper to be about an inch long. The longer your taper is, the longer your leaf will be. So here we've got our taper all finished. Now we're ready for the next step, and that's to do a set down. And here we're gonna hold our taper off the anvil about an inch and a half, and we're going to hit it on two sides, and that's gonna put a little notch, and you'll see what I mean. Here you can see what I mean after those two notches are put in. Now that section on the opposite side of the taper below the notch, that's going to become the stem. So now we're just going to thin that out. It's important to put that notch at the edge of the anvil every time, because if you don't, every time you hit, you'll put a new little mark there. So we do keep going back and forth between those two sides, holding that little notch against the edge of the anvil. Forging out the stem and thinning that down probably takes the most time of this whole effort. The really great part about the induction forge is there's no downtime. After you heat your workpiece, you're at the anvil, and you're right back to heating your workpiece for 10 seconds and back to the anvil. So it's really, really fast.
Hey folks, wanted to mention our sponsor, Maritime Knife Supply. If you need anything for knife making, whether it's steel, hand material, tools, equipment, whatever it is, you can get it at Maritime Knife Supply. They even carry the perfect blade sharpening attachment by yours truly. So if you're up in Canada and you need a sharpening attachment, go get one at Maritime.
All right, we're ready to move our focus back to the leaf. Now we're gonna put its backside down, so the notch is up, and a couple solid hits, and that's going to make a flat spot on the top of the leaf. And now I'm just going to concentrate on one side of the leaf or the other. I do that by holding the leaf at the edge of the anvil so I don't hit the anvil, and I'm using the round part, either the front of the rounding hammer, or the rounding side of the hammer, or the back side of the rounding side of the hammer, depending on which side the leaf is on. Here I'm focusing my blows with the back side of the rounding hammer, and I'm only hitting on the edge of the leaf. I'm trying to keep a medial ridge in the center of that leaf. So that's what I'm concentrating on here. Now I'm going to move my attention back to the stem, thin that out a little bit, and then we're going to twist it off the bar. Sorry, this was a bit off camera, but I'm just taking some scrolling tongs and just twisting that leaf off of the original bar. I didn't quite get it done in one heat, so we're going back for a little more. And there we go, separated from the bar. Now I'm just gonna taper and round off the stem a little bit more, just so it looks a little more natural. Oops, went flying a little bit. I got a different pair of tongs now to hold these a little tighter, and we're going to continue just thinning out the stem. And now the final step, we're just going to give that stem a little twist to make it look kind of cool, and we should be done.
So there's the leaf all completed. Really simple project, pretty fun. Great practice for blacksmithing and bladesmithing is to do leaves. I did a bunch of these when I first started. Haven't done one in a while. You know, it's not perfect, but yeah, they're pretty fun. About the induction forge, I love this machine. It's just amazing to be able to have this in the shop. Doesn't heat up the shop like a forge does. It can be indoors. Really, really cool machine. If you guys are looking for one of these, there's links down in the video description. Check them out and start forging with your induction forge. Thanks, folks. We'll see you on the next one.